friendly pilot guy from Southeast. So what you need to do is you need to get another job. I can't figure out what you want to do. No, I know what you need to do. You need to do nothing for me. I'd be really happy about it. Absolutely nothing. Yeah. I'm late. Be like me and Howie. We never accomplished anything anyway. You always made everything look so much easier for us than we did. Making us jealous all the time. So anyway, have a good, uneventful retirement. And by the way, thanks very much for being the one corner of the hubba. That was, you can't imagine how much that meant to me. So thank you. And say hi to everybody. And much love, Richard. You're the best.
All right, so we're gonna just, first of all, I wanna spend a couple minutes. Rich, we know, has been a huge part of Southeast and a number of strategic initiatives. And I want to just touch on a few, but actually what I didn't put up here is what I think I have quite a strong appreciation for, and that is that Rich really had this incredible business sense to negotiate. And there are so many both payer contracts and hospital contracts that I got to witness very early in my career some of those proceedings. And I know Gene's here, hopefully still. Gene, are you around? Hi, Gene. Yes, you've been a partner in crime in this process. And
you were a good student.
I was, yes. I say that. I remember just sitting there with usually a pretty hostile administration, much more so than we've been fortunate to have recently. And in some of those meetings with the hospital, I just remember sitting there, not saying a word, and thinking, thank God that Rich is in this room right now, and I would never want to be in his shoes, because you know they were some challenging times, but he never sweated it out. You never could tell he was nervous or concerned, and he never lost his cool unless it was very deliberate. And the few times that he did were very effective. So I appreciate that aspect of what you've done for this group and you know where you've positioned us with the commercial payers and with the hospital. Just a couple other things. So there was actually a billing company quite a while back that Rich was one of the people that really helped put together that was owned by Southeast and for a number of years actually provided billing for more groups, I think, the largest radiology billing practice in the whole region at the time. And a few other things, and I think part of this reflects the team that Rich was a part of. And, you know, not only Bill Green, Joe Stock, Jim Husted, and, you know, later on a number of other people, but this core group did really some amazing stuff. And I know I feel blessed to have come into a practice that was just so strong, had such a strong foundation. There was issues like screening mammography, which was just coming on board as a screening modality, and Rich, along with the rest of the team, and Joe, were right there with the administration putting up the first outpatient screening in the Valley, from what I understand.
Without the administration?
Well, that was without. Media medical imaging, this was something that was really pushed by Rich and Jim and Joe and Bill, and has been very successful, as was Southeast Medical Imaging. I know Joe was a huge part of the design and operation, and Rich really, you know, had the business acuity to really convince the hospital to allow Southeast to own and operate this imaging center, which I think still to this day is one of the shining stars for the health system. So a lot of things, the growth of the practice in the years that he was here, from really 12 radiologists, actually some of which were radiation oncologists, to now up to 24, 25 radiologists, and still growing. The last thing I just want to point out, RRI. So I joined the group in 1998, and I remember for at least a few years what it was like to take call and to stay up, John's shaking his head, stay up all night and reading those CTs from home, but it was still a continuous drip, drip, drip of call. And around 2000, I think it was, Jonathan Schlockman joined our group. And Jonathan had a dream to move to Israel and to start a company of teleradiology and provide those services to U.S. practices. And that was his dream, but it was, I think, Rich, he had the business sense and the creativity, and I think he saw an opportunity and really was a critical part in putting this entity together and not only really significantly impacting our lifestyles for the members of Southeast, but there was quite a bit of financial advantage too. And the return on the investment for this practice over those years was pretty significant. And this was, again, having that foresight, because teleradiology was in its infancy. This was not something that everybody did at the time. You want to talk about Jonathan? You worked quite a bit with him.
Well, I'll just say, you know, it was a great opportunity, and Gene played a big part in it. Those of you who have had to have discussions with Jonathan is a wonderful guy. Those of you who have had to have business discussions with Jonathan would know how unusual they could be, and how unusual they would be, and you know, Jean would come out shaking her head from being on the phone, and I'm sure she recorded those conversations for amusement. You know, she would hear.
I am truly at a loss for words that may actually surprise some of you. For this day that somehow I thought would never actually come, your retirement from radiology and Southeast Radiology. I am so grateful to have learned so much from you over the years, and you've been one of the most important mentors to me in my professional life, in my life, and Southeast Radiology has been really, really blessed to have somebody to lead them for all these years that always look to do the right thing, always look at the long term over expediency, and always had the bigger picture and the interest of the entire group first and foremost in mind. And I've been personally lucky to have learned so much from you over these years. I wish you and Marion the best of luck in this next stage of life. Hopefully you won't be a stranger. Hopefully you can come for an extended visit and see the practice that we built together here in person someday. Best of luck.
Jonathan's a good guy. When Jean would come out, she'd come out and she'd say, I kept hearing you say, now Jonathan. And she said, it's a real father-son relationship. But on the other hand, he's the only son of mine, I think, who ever really listened to me. So
that is so funny, because I was telling my husband to drive down to that a little bit about the Israeli practice. And I said, you know, Rich dealt with John superlatively, because he just created himself as John's father. And he treated him like a son, and that was a very effective way to negotiate with Jonathan, who was not easy. But they did have a father-son relationship.
All right, I'm going to speed it up a little bit. I know that there's still a few things I want to cover here. First of all, the point of this slide, we know that Rich really believes that physicians should be engaged. And he practiced what he preached, and he was engaged throughout his career. Just with the medical staff, he served on numerous different committees, from the GME committee to even the medical executive committee. Clearly, finance has been his sweet spot, and that's where he spent a lot of his time with the medical staff in the hospital. Including serving for a number of years on the CKHS Board of Directors as part of their finance committee, until you start looking, I guess, a little too deep into their finances. And sorry here. But tireless volunteer really was what Rich was. So pretty much throughout his entire career, he was involved in local, state, and really, pardon me? National organized radiology, and it was really tireless volunteer effort for him. So I was pretty amazed actually going through his CV and looking at all the different positions he had, you know, just locally, the president of the Greater Delaware Valley Society of Ultrasound. I'm not sure if they're still around, but no. And the Philadelphia Rankin Race Society. We know about his involvement with the PRS. He served pretty much in every capacity you could, from the president on down, along with many different committees. He was the chairman of the PA Rad MSO, which was a very important and powerful position. I'm going to switch with you because I got to change it here. And then with the ACR. And so the ACR, many different committees that he worked with, everything from the Rad Pack Board of Directors, a variety of the nominating committees and so forth. So it's been decades that he has been a presence and part of the leadership for the ACR. The other thing that a lot of people didn't really realize is how much he lobbied on behalf of Southeast, on behalf of radiology in Pennsylvania and at the national level. And whether he was going to DC or going to Harrisburg, meeting with various politicians, local, federal, state, it was a lot of work. And it was volunteer work that you did, and you did it and didn't really expect much in return, but I think we all benefited from that. A lot of these accomplishments were then formally acknowledged. In 2000, he was given that very honorable induction as a fellow in the ACR, which is not on your CV, by the way. I'm surprised, it should be. Now, just to contrast, filling his shoes. So I really knew that this was something I could not do. This kind of illustrates, and this is my last trip to DC with Ellen, and that's, you know, the Washington Monument. We were working hard that day. I think this was Rich's last trip to DC. In the White House with Barack Obama. Now, I must admit, though, you were not on behalf of radiology, right? But I'm sure this is probably one of your more memorable photos.
It certainly is.
You want to comment on that?
Well, first of all, it's memorable to me because my grandchild was what, 2 months old at the time, meeting the president, and promptly fell asleep. When Brett worked in the White House and was leaving the White House, and apparently it's traditional for the president to meet with the person who is leaving and his family, and Brett was kind enough to have all of us together, and it really was a momentous moment of which I was extremely proud.
Yeah, it's a great photo. All right, so we know Rich didn't accomplish all this on his own, correct? Marion Deutsch? Must be German, right? So, 1967, you met in med school.
I was in medical school. She was a senior. A junior.
You were
a sophomore in college.
Yeah. Partners in crime. Now, I can tell from the photos you really had a good time there for a number of years. There's a lot of photos like this. Actually, I thought before I knew Rich grew a beard, I thought Rich was in the Speedo. And then, it was the other way around. Yeah. But so for a number of years, they were able to have some fun. But it didn't take long, and they settled down and decided to really work on the family. And in 1971, Adam came along. I love this photo because when I read stories to my kids, it was Horton Hears a Who and Curious George Goes to the Hospital. Yeah. Now, Adam had to suffer through the biography of Huey Long. As a pretty progressive Southern Democrat.
Demagogue, actually.
So, do you remember that story?
No.
A couple years later, Amy came along. That's a beautiful, smiling picture. And Brett, in 79, closed out the family. So, do you want to introduce your family here real quick?
Yeah, sure.